This clip is brought to you by SaveWithConrad.com. Today, because, well, I'm excited. We're talking about one of my favorite wrestlers as a kid, but then, well, you grow up and you learn some more about some folks. And of course, today is no different. It's the Ultimate Warrior, Jim Hellwig, born in June 16th, 1959. That's the reason we're covering him. He just celebrated a birthday. He's about 50 miles outside of Indianapolis and very early on decides he wants to get into bodybuilding and becomes an amateur bodybuilder. And fast forward, when he's on the West Coast, he meets a fellow named Rick Bassman. And before you know it, he is headed down the path of becoming a professional wrestler. Rick Bassman is a name that has been synonymous with a lot of big stars over the years. What can you tell us about Rick, Jim?
Entrepreneur, a big time entrepreneur. He had a wrestling school out there, had a little promotion, in Southern California, and a lot of stars are congregating in Southern California. They may not be as congregated right now as they once were in that respect, but nonetheless, Rick was an entrepreneur. He was a promoter, you know, always looking for the next gig, a hustler, but a very, forward thinking guy. And he kept in contact with us at WWE back in my talent relations days, always with an idea, with a for a talent. I got this guy, I got that guy. So that's where I was introduced to John Cena, because Rick Bassman, in addition to all the guys like Sting and Ultimate Warrior that he was affiliated with, he also had, among others, John Cena. And that was my biggest get out of his camp, was going out there and scouting John Cena, meeting him, talking with him, getting to know him, and then signing him. You know, I tell the story before that I took a red eye back from LAX to New York City, and I went straight to the office. I probably looked a little disheveled because I was flown all night. And I told Vince that I think I just signed our main eventer for WrestleMania in about 5 years. I'd like to go back and do my research to see how long it actually was, but Vince thought I was sleep deprived. He said, "You need to go home and shower." and come back to work or something like that. So in other words, he didn't celebrate my signing as fervently as I did until he met John. And then he was all in. He saw what I saw, you know, a smart guy that loved the business, but a real student of the game, not a bullshit student of the game where you just memorize somebody's Wikipedia page. He understood the business and he respected the business. So he came out of the Bassman camp, and I think that was, I don't know, was it UPW or something like that? I'm not sure.
It's been so long ago. That's right, yeah.
And that's, Bassman was that guy. He was a promoter, entrepreneur, hustler, you know, loved the business. I'm sure he still does. But I haven't talked to him in years. I think he's out of the pro wrestling side of things. But anyway, he was the guy that gave talents that lived in that area an opportunity to get noticed. So he did a great service for a lot of the wannabe pro wrestlers that lived in Southern California, because he was accessible, local, and he had the ear of WWE. I don't know how many times Bruce went out there to scout. At least he said he was scouting.
I love you for that. Well, the way he first gets Hellwig involved is through an outfit called Power Team USA. And this was quite the phenomenon back in the day. How would you explain Power Team USA, where these guys are, you know, doing sort of strongman feats on a big stage and trying to give inspirational messages, but they're in, like, I don't know, red, white, and blue wind suits, right?
Yeah. It was pretty gimmicky, actually. Pretty gimmicky. Interesting concept. I don't know that I'd, you know, there's some of those guys he had that I don't know if I'd want to get motivated by, but nonetheless, it was an interesting concept and idea and something that he could manage and pull off. And it was colorful. It was different. All those are good things in pro wrestling. Having a situation where you don't take your eyes off somebody is what he tried to create, and he did a nice job there. So Rick was an asset at a point in time there for WWE, because everybody wanted to come to WWE. You know, he may have been sending stuff to WCW as well. Hell, I don't know. Eric could probably tell you that better than I. But we had a good rapport with him. You know, he always had backstage passes and tickets to Southern California WWE events. And he was always his presence is always there. So but it was a kind of a gimmicky thing. But the nice thing about it, out of it came Warrior and Sting out of that group. And, you know, he got them booked in Memphis, which is very famous for booking just about anybody that was different or new to give it a try. That's one thing about Lawler and Jarrett. They didn't have any hesitation about trying something new and a new talent, because Lawler could work with anybody. He proved that for about 50 years. So, you know, he could work with anybody. So that was the situation there. And it didn't last long in Memphis. And then we got them, changed their name, and then Mid-South. So, and we'll talk about that. But Bassman, interesting dude. And I always appreciated his efforts on our behalf, and my behalf personally. So it was all good stuff.
Hey, it's Conrad Thompson. Thanks for checking out the podcast here on YouTube. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell so you get a notice anytime we upload some new content. And go save yourself some money right now. If you're in a 30-year loan or you have credit card debt, it's not a matter of if I can save you money. It's a matter of how much. Find out right now for free at SaveWithConrad.com.